community. We're going to go ahead and jump into this training. It's going to be open dialogue, but I don't want to, you know, belabor the time, okay? So I'm going to share my screen here. All right. Do you all see my screen?
Yes.
So one of the things that I really want to help all of our authors understand is really how to maximize your book sales and how to effectively use your time in doing that. And so you do that by creating a sales system. A lot of times as authors, people feel like the quality of their book is going to sell the books. They feel like everything except what they have to bring to the table is going to sell the book. But the point is, you've got to put in the work. God, even if God came down from heaven and wrote that book for you, you still got to go out there and put in the work in order to get those books sold, okay? Most effective way to do that is by creating a system of selling so that you're working more efficiently and not spinning your, you know, spinning your wheels. So the problem, like I said, the problem is that most people believe that, you know, the book is going to sell itself. So what we're gonna do today is learn how to effectively sell. I wanted to kind of preface this. There is a guy named Grant Cardone. Has anybody ever heard of Grant Cardone? Okay, we got one or two. Grant Cardone, I don't believe in everything that he talks about, but he has one thing that he really talks about that I really believe in, and that's called the 10X. And 10X, his 10X philosophy is anything that you want to do, anything you want to achieve, it's going to take 10 times more effort than you think in order to achieve it. And I think that we have to really understand that when we think about selling books and how many books do we want to sell. For some people, it's not about the money. For some people, it's about the missions. For some people, it's about the souls. But in any case, whether it's you want to reach 1 million sales so you can make $1 million, or if you want to reach 1 million souls so that you can help 1 million people, it's going to take 10 times the effort in order to achieve that goal. So it's good to have that as a backdrop as we talk about what we're about to talk about, because it's going to help to put you in perspective how to go about doing these things. All right, so let's talk about what is a sales system, all right? A sales system is an efficient way and an effective way to reach your target audience and convert that target audience into a buyer. So many people, we go out and we kind of bounce from one thing to the next. Oh, there's a you know, carnival over here. Let me go over here and walk the audience and sell some books. That's great. There's a book signing over here. I'm gonna go do this book signing. But we're doing random things hoping to create a consistent flow of income. What a sales system does is it creates a systematic approach to funneling business to you, right? You wanna create a system of activities, a system of events, so that when people come into your and when people come into your gravitational pool, they get sucked into what you're doing because you've created a system where the moment they see you, once they take interest in what you are about, that leads them into another funnel of your system. So that's what a sales system is. So basically, just to recap that, because I feel like I kind of rambled on that, but just to recap that, it is a systematic approach to generating leads and turning those leads into buyers. So there are 5 pillars of a successful sales system. I'm gonna give y'all time to write that down. 5 pillars of a successful sales system, all right? So the first pillar of your sales system is getting exposure. I call this getting touches. Benita, unmute for a second.
Yes.
If you were in a crowd of people and you saw me, and we're in a crowd of 100 people, you saw me and you want to get my attention, right? It's very loud, so yelling is not going to do it, right? And I'm within arm's reach. What would you do? What would you do to get my attention?
Walk over, introduce myself, and begin to talk about my interest in publishing my book and ask to see if you're able to help with that and if we can share information and contact so we can stay in touch.
Okay. That's awesome. But you would probably reach out and touch me on the shoulder, right?
Probably, but not. Yes, to be real, yes.
Yeah, you reach out and you touch me. Okay. Yeah. And that's what we need to do, essentially. To get exposure, we've got to touch people. We've got to get their attention. Now, getting touches, though, it doesn't mean that you're going to get a sale. Getting touches doesn't mean you're going to, every time you put out a social media post, you're not going to get a sale from that social media post, right? However, what you may get is some recognition from people. They'll start to see your color scheme. They'll start to see your book title. Just like Terry just said to Marcus, she said, oh, wow, wait a second. I saw a movie that's similar to your book, right? Because she had been exposed to Marcus's book, she had a recollection of that. So when it comes to getting touches, I want you all to look at this in the same way as a farmer planting seed. He throws out thousands of seeds. Not every seed will grow. However, you know that those seeds that are in good ground are growing, okay? They are growing. I'm going to give a story. Adrian Davis and I went on a fellas cruise. We went on a cruise, and we, of course, you're interacting with different people. So we were interacting with this group, this family reunion, this group of young ladies and women who were on a family reunion. I passed out my business card. This is on a cruise to the Bahamas now, not Nashville. They're not from Nashville. They don't know me. This is on a cruise to the Bahamas. A couple of months later, I get a call, and the lady says, my boss wants to write a book, and you're the only person I know in the publishing business. So exposure may not mean that you get a sale immediately, but whatever you can do, you want to expose your name, you want to expose your book, you want to expose your title to as many faces, as many eyes as possible. Get as many touches as you can. So can somebody tell me we'll take about maybe 30 seconds. If we can get quick responses, can somebody tell me a couple of ways to get exposure? Adrian Davis, can you give me one?
So sure. Right before I run out of here, I think if you're doing anything that has content that can be used by businesses, you really cater a message to the organization and information that they would be interested in, and then just kind of give a little bit of that information for it. So if it's content, you give it for free, not giving your whole product away, but give it something that they would be very much interested in.
So basically just talking to people. Okay.
Exactly.
What's another way? Tammy Otuku, what's a way to get exposure for your book?
I actually did an interview with one of my friends, and it was really good. Mm-hmm. And I think that was a way. And another thing, I'm a member of Lake Providence Baptist Church. I actually put my pastor in the book. And that's why we got like 5,000 members. So eventually that word will get out.
Wow. Okay. So just, what's that called? Cross marketing?
Yeah. Cross-marketing.
Yeah. Collaboration. Bring somebody else in. Exactly. And we'll talk about that at some point. But just to throw this out, it's always good. We have a client named Patricia Davis. She wrote a book about her husband's death due to pulmonary disease. So she
can pulmonary
fibrosis. She connected with organizations and health facilities that deal with that so that she can get that exposure. Okay. So that's an idea. If you have a book and you have some kind of connection to other organizations, other people, bring those people and organizations in so that you can get more exposure. The number one way of exposure in today's social media world is social media. Please, let's grasp this really quickly, okay? I can post something on social media, and everyone who likes it, will show for their friends as well that they've liked the picture or the post. So now my one post has connected to maybe a network of 5,000 people because of the fact that that one person liked it, right? So social media is the best way to get exposure. Now, the way to quantify whether you're getting the likes that you need or getting the exposure you need, as you post on social media and you get likes, that's a serious lead. Like, that person liked something that you posted, reach out to them and say, hey, thanks for the like. I hope you'd be interested in getting my book. So these are ways to take that exposure and turn them into leads, okay? I'm going to move on. So the first pillar is get exposure. Get touches. Touch as many people as you can. Your touches are not your primary target. They can be people who have no need for your product, but they may know someone who does. So do not feel like as you get exposure, if you don't get sales immediately, that you're not doing what you're supposed to do. You are doing what you're supposed to do. All right, the next pillar is prospecting. Prospecting is actually going out and looking for buyers. A lot of times we think about prospectors, we think about door-to-door salesmen, vacuum cleaner salesmen, right? But guess what? As an author, you too have a group of people out there that you need to be trying to reach. Whether it's organizations, like Tammy, you just had a great example of what can happen if you reach the right people. You know, if you reach somebody who has connections or inroads into the prison system, the military, right? So you know now, some of the prospecting that you can be doing is putting down a list of all of these major connections and reaching out to them and saying, hey, I just had these prisons order my book. You don't have to say it was a friend. You just say, I just had these prisons order my book for their inmates. Would you also like to order my book for your patients, or would you like to order my book for your constituents?
Oh, okay.
So prospecting means you are actively looking for people to buy your book. So these are things that you will be doing either on a daily basis or within the week. One of these five things you'll be doing, one of these five things throughout the week. The next one is adding value. All right, let me explain what I mean by this. If you go online and you post something that helps your audience, like a blog, a video blog, you just get online and give some information about how, you know, provide resources, you are adding value to your audience. The greatest way for you to build your audience is to first provide value. In the sales business, we talk about what's in it for me. Everybody you talk to and everyone you ask to read your book, that is the main question on their mind. What's in it for me? Now, what tends to happen is we kind of get spoiled in those first few sales because we're actually selling to our immediate circle of influence, our friends, our family. So we get a little spoiled, right? We get spoiled because they are really supporting us because they love us. And so that's what's in it for them, to support a family member. But then when we go outside of that immediate circle of influence, those people want to know, what's in it for me? Why am I going to give you $10, $20 to buy your book? I don't know you. I could really care less about your story. So by adding value on a weekly basis or daily basis, providing something, providing a resource, providing some kind of value to your audience or to your target market, then you become an authority for them. And once you become that authority for them, they will buy whatever you have. They will listen to whatever you have. So the worst thing you can do is say, support me, buy my book. That's the worst thing you can do. Because guess what? Everybody needs money. Everybody has something they want support for, right? So you've got to go into every pitch with how your book or how your product is going to benefit the person you're trying to sell the book to. I went to a conference just recently, and the tip that they gave is when you are presenting and telling people what you do, don't say, this is what I do. You always start off with a question. You start off with a question like, let's say for me, for Truevine Publishing, I would start off with the question like, well, do you know how everybody wants to publish a book, right? So what that does is that immediately presents my value to the people. I'm not going in and saying, I publish books. I'm going in with the question, you know how everyone wants to write a book, or everybody thinks they can write a book. So Marcus, an example, Marcus, for you, you would say, well, you know how we're dealing with this, you know, the Second Amendment and the gun control issues, right? And so now we got a conversation going, all right? So that's just a tip outside of what I was really talking about. Sorry about that. I went off on a bunny trail. All right. So pillar number four, generate income. You have to have things in your week, in your day that are focused on generating income. Book signings, events where you can be a vendor and sell books, going door to door and actually asking for sales. These are generating income. These are income generating activities. So you want to include these in your week or in your day, however you want to, you know, reach your audience. If you're going to do something every day or every week, then one of these four needs to be done throughout the week. So just to recap that, generating income is anything you do that actually brings money to the table. And pillar number five is build your referral team. Tammy, that was a great example of a referral team, is someone who has connections, who's willing to support you, and they will refer your book to other people, refer your product to other people, or refer your services to other people. When building your referral team, it needs to be a mutual benefit. If someone provides you 50 book sales and you make $500, please give them $50 or $100. Give them something, because if they could bring 50 books to the table, they can bring 100. But if you use them and they don't get anything back, there's no benefit for them to keep doing that. So when you're building your referral team, you want as many people on that referral team as possible. So with these five pillars of your sales system, you're going to be getting exposure every day. You're going to be prospecting every day. You're going to be providing value that will bring more people to your platform, and you're going to be generating income. Now, I want to talk about how this works with the 10X system. We talked about the fact that if you want to achieve something, it's going to take 10 times more effort than you think. So I got an exercise here, and this is the equation for success based on the 10X philosophy. All right, Tammy, how many books would you like to sell in a 90-day period?
300, 400.
All right, great. Bonita, how many books would you like to sell in a 90-day period?
I'm going to say about 500.
Okay. Marcus, how many books would you like to sell in a 90-day period?
10,000.
Marcus has the potential. He's not being silly. He has that potential. All right. Okay. I'm sorry, I went back. Okay. So we have our numbers. We have our numbers. All right, Tammy, Bonita, Marcus, you want to sell 400, 500, and 10,000 books. Now, what that means in this scenario, in this philosophy, that means you need to reach 10 times that many people, all right? So if you want to sell 300 books, you need to reach 3,000 people. I know that may sound daunting, that may sound intimidating, but I'm going to tell you how this system helps you do that. Benita, you want to sell 500? That means you need to reach 5,000. Marcus wants to sell 10,000. That means he needs to reach 100,000. Now, let me show you how this is possible. We talked about exposure. When you effectively use social media, you can easily reach 1,000 people in a day or 1,000 people in a week. Now, like I said, not all of those people are going to buy, but if you reach 1,000 people, the averages, if we got a 10% conversion rate, we should be able to get at least 100 actual inquiries, which are leads. These are people who showed interest, all right? Now, a lot of times we overlook this opportunity because we get likes online on our social media posts, and then we don't follow up with those likes. When those people like your post, when those people click on your book and they hit like, that means they look, they came to the store, they came to the window, and they said, oh, look at that, that's interesting, right? And now it's your job to bring them into the store and get them to buy. So we got 3 minutes, so I'm gonna wrap this up quickly, okay? So every time you post online, you're trying to get more people to see your book. So if you're posting online one day a week, is that gonna be sufficient to get you the 5,000 touches that you need, right? If you're only talking to people about your book once a week, is that gonna be sufficient to reach 5,000 people? If you're not doing any interviews, contacting any bloggers to see if they can have you on their show, are you doing the work you need to do to reach 5,000 people? So this is how we quantify what our activities are doing. When we're posting online, doing interviews, passing out postcards, all of these things just to get somebody to look at our title, look at our book cover, these are all effective ways to get leads. Those leads then turn into prospects. So the lead is someone who's interested, and then once they're interested and you engage them, then you turn them into a prospect. A prospect is somebody who has made some kind of commitment to at least hear you out, okay? And then the prospect turns into a conversion. So you gave them, you got their attention, they showed interest, you pull them in, you sell them on your product, and then they become a buyer or they tell you, no, I'm not interested, all right? So this is the end. Any questions?
I think you hit on everything.
Thank you, Mr. Bond.
To me, but I hope this was of help, and we can do this again. I'll set another meeting and we'll meet up again. But in the meantime, send me questions, send me anything you need so we'll know what to talk about next time, okay? The world, you're gonna change.